to GRTV. Now we can discuss about squamous cell carcinoma of oral cavity. Squamous cell carcinoma of oral cavity is more common in chronic smokers and chronic nut powder chewing habit, and those patients who will have chronic etiology of chain smoking and nut powder chewing habit. So even reverse smoking also will cause this squamous cell carcinoma of soft palate, hard palate, and dorsum of the tongue, and onto the buccal mucosa or gingival tissue. Like that, anywhere in the oral cavity is squamous cell carcinoma is cauliflower like growth, means it looks like a cauliflower, and there will be depressions and elevations and crevices and the grooves and crevices. So this cauliflower like growth will attract, the food particles will stagnate or impact onto the grooves and crevices of this squamous cell carcinoma on the superficial layer of this squamous cell carcinoma. So in this chronic cases, there will be tender palpable submandibular lymph nodes, cervical lymph nodes, and sublingual lymph nodes will be tender, palpable, and pain on percussion, pain on pressing. So these lymph nodes will metastasis, and the cancer cells may enter into cardiac muscle or lung tissue, or even into the neural cells. So if there is any metastasis, the patient will complain of pain and tender palpable lymph nodes. The patient will feel the tender palpable and fixed lymph nodes at the cervical area, submandibular region, and sublingual area. So the patients, because of this growth in the oral cavity, patient complaining of difficulty in chewing, difficulty in swallowing, difficulty in deglutition, and there will be profuse foul smell from the oral cavity because of this food deposits or fluid deposits or food impaction into the grooves and crevices of this cauliflower like growth. There will be super infection from lichen planus, white fungal infections also, because of chronic severity of this squamous cell carcinoma also leads to this super infections of lichen planus and fungal infections. So there will be purulent exudate, and there will be pus discharge, and there will be fluids from, because of fermented food will liberate so much of bad smell onto the this cauliflower like growth of this squamous cell carcinoma. So patient the taste will be distasteful, and he can't deglutate, he can't swallow food, he can't drink water or milk or even fluids also, because it will regurgitate, it will come out from the oral cavity, and there will be dribbling of salivary secretions from the oral cavity, and there will be a symmetry of mouth. If the right side of buccal mucosa affected with squamous cell carcinoma, there will be the angle of the mouth will be deviated to opposite side because of this growth will there will be cricket ball size growth onto the right side of patient's mouth, and the angle will be deviated to opposite side, and the speech is we can't identify what the patient is talking about his complications. So the speech is impaired, and the deglutition also very difficult, and difficulty in swallowing, difficulty in chewing, because there will be the occlusion also. He can't occlude. There will be incompetent lips, because the growth will push. The growth will expand the buccal mucosa so big, and the consistency, the flaccidity of muscles, and incompetent lips, and there will be a huge growth in the oral cavity, and the tongue can't accommodate in the oral cavity. There will be sometimes tongue bite because of non-availability of space to accommodate in this mandibular arch. So this cauliflower-like growth will expand 360 degrees, so that the asymmetry, sometimes the bone osteolysis, because there will be in the mandibular bone there will be hollow spaces, and there will be vacuum in the mandibular ridge and mandibular arch also. So the mandible is more prone to fracture, because this cancerous growth will weaken the mandibular teeth, and mandibular bone tend to fracture even if the patient ready to take soft consistency, medium consistency, and extra hard consistency food also, because the squamous cell carcinoma, because we have to educate, and we have to give counseling to the patients, those patients who will who are in vigorous and aggressive chain smoking, and aggressive pan chewing habit, and aggressive this nut powder chewing habit, and continuous habit of this pipe smoking, and reverse smoking, and bad habits keeping tobacco leaf in the labial side, buccal side, or lingual side, or palatal side, like that. So these are the bad habits which will stimulate the gingival tissue in a mutative model. There will be a tremendous tissue mutation in a oral cavity because of this chronic irritation of any etiology. Even sharpened edge and highly attrition cases, the mucosa will be proliferated like a cancerous growth, and patient will have so much of redness in the oral cavity, and profuse liquid discharge and pus discharge. Sometimes tongue bite, there will be blood oozing from the angle of the mouth, and oral cavity. So the we have to terminate the bad habits of palm chewing habit, reverse smoking habit, even a chain smoking habit, and this nut powder chewing habit, and pungent nut powders like palm parag, raja kaini, and tambaku, and betel nut chewing habit should be immediately stop, and we have to show the video presentation to customers so that they will have awareness program. We have to conduct awareness programs and counseling and this video presentations which will help, and they will get afraid of this carcinogenic and this highly cancerous squamous cell carcinoma appears very 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 looks very ugly, and so that they can avoid bad habits of different this thing. So gingival tissue may grow, the mandibular alveoli tissue may grow, or buccal mucosa may get irritate and grow like a cricket ball, and there will be metastasis. All the facial lymph nodes become tender and palpable, and fix there will be infiltration. They will infiltrate into the base of the lymph node, so that the fixity, if there is any fixity of lymph nodes into onto the base of the surface, definitely we can assess the cancer is malignant.